Hello. Today, let us look at pancreatic cancer. All kinds of cancer is bad, but pancreatic cancer is one of the worst ones. What is it that makes pancreatic cancer bad? Let's review the pancreas. The pancreas is actually a very important organ that helps control blood sugar as well as help us digest the food that we eat. If the pancreas is damaged by cancer, the pancreas is not able to do the job that it does for the body, which is helping us to digest the food we eat and also control the blood sugar by releasing insulin. The things that damage pancreas are cancer cells. The problem with cancer of the pancreas is that it is really very, very difficult to find out. By the time doctors find it, the cancer has already advanced to the late stages. Now, what causes pancreatic cancer? There are a lot of things that cause the pancreas to be cancerous. One of the things that does that is genetic. That is, if you have a genetic history of cancer, when you have somebody, a direct family member, maybe parents or brother, that has had a pancreatic cancer, that means that you have genetic predisposition to also have pancreatic cancer. It doesn't mean that you will have it. It just means that you have a better chance of getting it than someone who doesn't have pancreatic cancer in their family. The next thing that causes pancreatic cancer is diabetes. If you're diabetic and you have your blood sugar not under control, then you are also subjecting yourself to a better chance of having pancreatic cancer. The next thing will be chronic inflammation of the pancreas. If your pancreas is always having problem and it has inflammation, and that is something that's always keep happening chronically, you could be subjected to a pancreatic cancer. The next thing is overweight. If you're obese and your weight is excessive and you can't control it, you are also subjecting yourself to a higher chance of having pancreatic cancer as well as other diseases. Smoking. If you're somebody that smoke, you know that smoking is not good for you, but then it also adds that smoking is a risk factor for having pancreatic cancer. Older age. Pancreatic cancer is most of the time found in people that are a lot older, from age of 65 and above. That one, we can't do anything about it because it's just the fact that more people that get pancreatic cancer are people of the older age. Now, what are the signs and symptoms of pancreatic cancer? How do you know, or what are things that indicate that you might be having pancreatic cancer? One of the things is loss of appetite. People that have pancreatic cancer, they usually have loss of appetite. They don't feel like eating anything, and then they have a lot of weight loss. The second sign of pancreatic cancer is blood clots. Just having a blood clot out of no reason is a concern. So that is something that needs to be checked out by a doctor. Fatigue. If you're always feeling tired for no reason and you try all you can and it's like you are chronically feeling weak and tired, there might be a chance of you having a pancreatic cancer. So it needs to be checked out. If you're having pain in your upper abdomen, abdomen, radiating to the back. Having pain in your upper abdomen that radiates to the back is another symptom of pancreatic cancer. The next thing is depression. Are you feeling depressed for no reason? And you haven't been diagnosed as being depressed, but you constantly feeling depressed, that might also be a sign of pancreatic cancer. Dark urine. If you're urinating and your urine is dark, it could be a possibility of pancreatic cancer. The last thing is yellowing of your skin and yellowing of the white of the eye could be also a sign of pancreatic cancer. You notice that most of these signs and symptoms also appear in other diseases. So it's really important that if you're having all these signs and symptoms, that you get checked out by your doctor to rule out, make sure that you don't have pancreatic cancer. How do we then prevent pancreatic cancer? Is there anything we can do to prevent it? Well, two things that we can do anything about. If you have a family history that you can't do anything about other than just making sure that you control the other conditions that will subject you, those are the risk factors. You can control them. Now, another thing that is a risk factor is your age. That also you can't do anything about. Just know that the older age are also predisposed to having pancreatic cancer. You can start smoking. Stopping smoking will go a long way in helping you to prevent pancreatic cancer. Weight loss. It is important for you to keep your weight under control. Lose weight if you're obese, and also keep it off. That will help you to prevent a lot of risk factors and a lot of diseases, including pancreatic cancer. Healthy living, healthy diet, eating the right fruits and vegetables. Those are also a good thing that will help you to prevent pancreatic cancer. The last thing that you should be doing is regular medical checkup. It's really important that you have regular medical checkup once a year so that your doctor will follow your medical history and be able to have a better chance of detecting if there is any indication of pancreatic cancer. These are really good advice that we all have to do in order to reduce the incidence of pancreatic cancer. Because pancreatic cancer, it is very deadly. Most of the time, by the time doctors make the diagnosis, it's already past the stage that not much can be done. So it's really important to do all we can to reduce the incidence, because I have seen a lot of things happening recently of people being diagnosed of pancreatic cancer, and within 6 months, a year, that they were diagnosed, they've already passed away, which is very, very unfortunate. It could affect every age group, but most of the time, the older you are, the more you have more risk of having pancreatic cancer. I hope this will help you to prevent this disease. We also have a blog that will be on this video that you can go and read more about it. Good luck.